We've talked about what we do when an equation has just one variable. If you notice, all of the stuff we did in the previous section just dealt with single variable equations. For this section, we're going to talk about what happens when we have multiple variables. Now, the thing you have to remember is that a variable is nothing more than a number in disguise. Everything you do with letters, you do with numbers. It doesn't always look like it, but that's what it is. And so to solve formulas are these equations that are made out of numbers. You might also hear them called literal equations. To solve these, we treat other variables like numbers. And then the final answer will be an expression, usually simplified as much as we can get. And so let's take a look at some examples. Now, 3x equals 15, this should be a very easy equation to you. We divide by 3, x equals 5. And we're all set. Well, if everything here is a letter, it's the exact same. If we want to solve for x, which means we isolate x, if we want to solve for x, we want to get x alone, which means we divide by w. And in this case, x equals y over w. If you notice, we do the exact same thing here for the exact same reason as before. The only difference is that we don't know what the letters are, so we just have to leave it as y over w. But we handle them the exact same way we would handle them if numbers were there. For example one, they ask us again to solve for x. To solve for a variable just means to do algebra to isolate that variable. And in this case, we want to get x alone. So we really just peel away everything but x. I'll begin with b. We'll subtract b from both sides. Now, y and b are not like terms. You could write it as negative b plus y. It's probably a little easier, though, to write it as y minus b. And then to solve, we just divide both sides by whatever is stopping us from getting x alone, which in this case is w. So we're going to divide both sides by w, and we get that x is equal to y minus b over w. And so you can see this is all the same stuff we've been doing, it's just a little more general. Let's take a look at example two. For example two, this time we want to isolate b, we want to solve for b. So let's take a look at where b is in this equation. We see that b is right there. So we're just going to peel everything away little by little until b is isolated. The easiest thing to do is subtract 5y. Remember, this is technically 1y, think invisible one. And so we'll now have ab is equal to wx. 1y minus 5y is negative 4y. Those are like terms because they both have y in them. And then what we're going to do, again, we want to get b alone. So what we want to do here is get rid of whatever isn't b. Well, b is connected to a, so we undo that connection by dividing by a. And we get here that b equals wx minus 4y over a. You can tell that these literal equations, these formulas, can often look very ugly, especially their solutions. But they're not really that bad to actually do. It's all the same math you've been doing thus far, it just looks a little different. Now, if you had to type these into WMAP, you have to be careful to put the top and the bottom in parentheses if they have multiple terms. If you were to type this into WMAP, example 1 would come out to y minus b over w, and example 2 would come out to wx minus 4y over a. Give these a shot, and try not to fear them too much, they do get easier. So get a little practice and you'll see.